नमस्ते बिटियाओं, सदा खुश रहिए। मायसेल्फ जेवीएन ब्रिजेश कुमार यादव, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माय डिजिटल क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड दिस लेक्चर फॉर बीएससी बीएड जेडबीसी सेकेंड सेम। पेपर नेम इज डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ क्रिप्टोग्राम्स। स्टूडेंट्स, वी वेयर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द क्रिप्टो फाइटा। ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द टॉपिक्स वी हैव कवर्ड सो फार, एंड अनदर लास्ट टॉपिक इज रिमेनिंग, दैट इज फॉसिल्स। ओके, सो टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम ऑफ द फैक्ट्स, डेफिनेशन, टाइप्स ऑफ फॉसिल्स। एज यू ऑल नो दैट ड्यूरिंग our lecture we used to discuss about paleontology. Paleontology is the study of fossils, a branch of biology which deals with the study of fossils. Okay, it has two branch, although it has many more branches, but only concerning to biology, this botany, we concern only two branches, zoology, that is paleontology and paleobotany. Since we are the student of botany, so we focus on botany parts, paleontobotany. Okay, so let's start some of the definition of fossil. Fossils are remains or imprint of plants or animals which are preserved from prehistoric times by the operation of natural conditions. These natural conditions we'll deal in detail later on. Fossils are found in sedimentary rocks. Students, try to focus on this concept, that which kind of rocks preserve these fossils. That is, you might be studied that there are three types of rocks: sedimentary, igneous, and metamorphic. So out of these three, sedimentary rocks are the important one for our concern. This sedimentary rocks are important for fossilization. So fossils are found in sedimentary rocks, asphalt deposits and coal, and sometimes in amber, which we'll discuss later, and certain other materials. I have already told that the scientific study of fossils is known as paleontology. Since we are the student of botany, so we concern to fossils like plants. So that branch of science known as paleobotany. Okay, students, you might be knowing that institute related to paleobotany is located in Lucknow. Now we are moving to see what kind of fossils are there. So on the basis of their formations, fossils can be categorized into three main types: actual fossil, imprint fossil, and petrified fossils. So we'll see them one by one. Actual fossils are those fossils in which intact plant body, animal body, parts such as bones, teeth, cells, amber are frozen in ice. In this type of fossils, the remains of soft and hard parts of the organism won't be altered. They are not going to change. So that's why they are actual fossils. Second is imprint. In imprint, molds are cast in mud, sand, and etc. that turn into rock. Imprint fossils are formed from an organism moving in same way, leaving behind the trace or track. If they leave any marks, trace, symbol behind that, that also act as a fossils. That also give us clue for the history of that organisms or that plant, animal, or parts. So these tracks are preserved when they are in clay, slick, dry, slowly, and is covered by other sediments, means different rocks. Especially in case of plants can also leave imprint fossil when they are covered by sediments. The leaf tissue that is degraded, leaving an imprint of where they leaf once was, where they were once. Okay, so in this way, leaf can also form imprint fossils. Now, putrefied fossils, which are the result of putrefaction, that process is known as putrefaction, results from the mineralization, the replacement of once living matter by minerals. Solution containing silicates, carbonates, iron or other minerals seep into the gap and spaces between the cells, first encasing the cells and eventually replacing the cell themselves. Over the time, as it pass on, minerals entirely replace the organic material and creating petrified fossils. So in this way, petrified fossils are formed, and this process is known as petrification. But there are other criteria for the classification of fossils. So on the basis of the fossil distribution, how they are distributed, where are occurrence, and by their characteristics, the fossils have been divided into different types, such as body fossils. Okay, in body fossils, we preserve entire organisms, whole organisms, in all altered form or altered hard part and naturally found mound and cast that are known as body parts. Fossils, you can see here, tribolites, the whole body is preserved, that is known as body fossils. Next is chemical fossils. When preserved paleoprotein, some of the chemicals like amino acids and structures, they results from recrystallization and carbonization process, they are grouped as a chemical fossils. Next one is trace fossils. When small parts, any clue, that footprint, trail, burrows and tubes of coprolites and fossilized eggs are found, they are known as trace fossils. Next one is living fossils. Livings, which ranges from ancient time upon the present day without any changes in their primitive characters, are known as living. And next one is pseudo. Certain structures of sedimentary or tectonic origin which resembles fossilized organic remains are termed as pseudo fossils, means they are false, they are not in original form. Okay, now some of the uses of fossils. What are the use of fossils? How can we use these fossils for our study, for our benefits? How they are significance? Then fossils can use in the study of chronostratigraphy, that is the concern with the age of strata and their time relation, how the earth strata has been formed and how they are related with different times. Next one is biostratigraphy, that is fossil contents of beds are used in interpreting the historical sequences. Now you are going to disclose the historical sequences. Next one is index fossil and correlation of rocks. Certain animals or plants remains are so characteristics of certain geographical origin that they are called as index fossil. Now these index fossils are used for the study of that particular rocks and particular time. They used in correlation with that areas. Now some of the other facts related to fossilization, that is the methods of determining age of fossils. How you are going to determine the age of fossils, how old these fossils are, where they were found, how they formed. All those aspects can be studied by different process. Out of these, there are two processes are there, radioactive clock methods and radioactive carbon method. But in your syllabus, only radioactive carbon method is there. So we'll focus on that only. This method, since you people are chemistry students, so in chemistry you might have studied that carbon dating. That same fundamental principle will apply over here to find out the age of fossils. You might have studied carbon 14, carbon 20 are there. So that principle apply over here, and this process was first discovered by W.F. Libby. And this method is quite accurate for relatively recent fossils. Nowadays, the age of fossils can be identified by this process. So students, today we have seen about fossils, the types of fossils, and how fossils can be determined. Okay, so for today, thank you very much.